I'm going to add a few shapes to the scene. A rectangle, an isosceles triangle, a ring, a cube, a right arrow callout, and a circle pie. What I want to show with these shapes are what LibreOffice calls extra handles. Some people refer to them as special handles. Our rectangle does not have any extra handles, but our triangle has one right here at the top. And we see a yellow circle within the blue square. And when our arrow is over it, it becomes a hand, allows us to drag and change our shape, in this case our triangle, from one side to the other, or we can go right back to the middle. Our ring also has a special handle. It's right here on the left-hand side. If I move it to the right, our ring becomes thicker. If I move it to the left, the ring becomes thinner. Our cube also has an extra handle, and moving that makes our cube thinner and longer, or taller and wider. Our circle pie has actually got two extra handles. These handles can adjust not only the width of the pie, but the direction it's pointing in without going into rotation mode, which we can also change it that way. Our right arrow callout has actually got three extra handles. This far left one changes the size of our box. This one in the middle changes the height of the area connecting the box to the arrow and the length of the arrow itself. Whereas this last one changes the width of the arrow. So lots of our shapes have extra handles. You just need to play with them to find out what they do. One last shape I want to comment about. It's this circle pie that I added to my custom toolbar in one of the first tutorials of the series. When I add that to my page, it's got a circle dashed line. When I let up my mouse, I've got a little line from the center of the pie to the edge. I've single clicked and my finger's off the mouse. I'm dragging it around so I can make full circle or the size of pie that I would like it to be, but once I click it again, it stays where it is. It's different than the circle pie from basic shapes, which we see here. This one gives us the two extra handles. This one that I added to my custom toolbar, that one does not give us any special handles. Once we've created it, that's what we have to work with. For this next part, I'm going to turn on my styles. And I've created some different color styles. I'm going to create one now just to remind us all of how I created all these other ones. Right click, new, color, area orange. And I'm going to click on the area tab and make this chart 10. So now I'm going to make my rectangle blue, my triangle green, my ring red, and my cube yellow. Now what I want to show with this is how when we move our shapes over one another, they're actually all on their own layer. And we can see the cube is in front of our ring, which is in front of our triangle, which is in front of our rectangle. Let's take a look at how to move our shape to a different shape layer. I'd right click on the shape I want to change the layer of and come down to arrange. Here we've got the option to bring in front, meaning bring in front of all of the shapes. Now that I'm in front, I can only send backward or send to the back. This is sending behind all of the shapes. Bringing forward just brings it up one shape. Now here, it looks like it didn't move at all, but right now, we're in front of the blue shape. So we have bring to front, which brings in front of all the shapes. Bring forward, which comes up one layer at a time. Send backwards, sends it back one layer at a time. Send to back, sends it to the way back. Now we have in front of object or behind object. Well, we're behind a lot of objects, so let's click that. And when I go over these other objects, it tells me which one do you want to be in front of. And that even works with objects that it's not connected to. It's any object on the page. So we will put it in front of the cube. And now we're in front of the cube. Behind the cube. Let's take a look at another example. I'm going to double click on circle. Make a big one. One a little smaller. One a little smaller. And then a real little one. And maybe make this one just a tad smaller. I'm going to make this one white with a black line. I'll make this one black. We'll make this one yellow. And our last one red. Now let's check our layers. Make sure that our black goes over our white. Our yellow goes over the black. And the red goes over the yellow. Now if we select all these and right click, we went over alignment in an earlier tutorial. So I'm going to click on center, make them all even top to bottom. And now I'm going to do the same thing and make them all centered vertically as well as horizontally. And now we've got a target.